Human evolution is one of our planet's greatest wonders. Millions of years ago, our ancestors were primitive primates. We slowly learned to walk on two legs, make tools, and harness fire. We then evolved from these simple hominins into a global civilization with art, culture, and advanced technology. To unravel the mysteries of human evolution, let's travel back in time to the humble roots of our family tree, when the ancestors of our ancestors first emerged on our planet. Our evolutionary journey began between 10 and 6 million years ago, during the late Miocene epoch. During the Miocene, many species of primates lived in subtropical and temperate forests across Africa and Eurasia. These animals spent most of their lives climbing through forest canopies, enjoying an abundance of seeds, nuts, and fruit. Primates flourished in these rich forests for a long time. However, gradual changes in the Earth's climate began altering the world's ecosystems. Dense forests gave way to more spacious biomes, like open woodlands, shrublands, and dry savannas. As forest canopies opened, primates had to find new ways of getting around. This ecological shift contributed to a key innovation in our family tree, the emergence of bipedalism. About 6 million years ago, the earliest hominins strode along the ground with a more upright posture, a characteristic that would forever define the human lineage. We don't know exactly which species of hominin was first to walk on two legs, but one of the most famous species is Australopithecus afarensis, which emerged roughly 3.9 million years ago. Fossil evidence suggests that A. afarensis spent most of its life on the ground and walked predominantly on its hind legs. It still had many ape-like qualities, like a low forehead and long arms. But alongside other hominins, A. afarensis and other Australopithecines bridged the evolutionary gap between earlier primates and more modern humans. Our evolutionary journey is often depicted as a simple chain of adaptations, as if our family tree evolved one species at a time. In reality, many hominins, some more advanced than others, lived side by side, often competing for resources and territory. For example, Homo habilis, the first member of our genus, probably lived alongside several species of Australopithecines. But Homo habilis had a nuanced advantage, a larger brain. In the course of human evolution, this marks the first significant increase in hominin brain size, expanding from roughly 400 cubic centimeters to over 600 cubic centimeters. Directly equating larger brains with higher intelligence is a bit too simplistic, but in the case of Homo habilis, there was likely a correlation. They were highly intelligent primates for the time, and used tools to exploit a wide range of ecological niches. They competed against animals at multiple trophic levels, gathering fruit and seeds, hunting for small animals, and scavenging carcasses. Homo habilis thrived on our planet for roughly 700,000 years, but it likely suffered immensely from climate change and ultimately died out. It also may have struggled to keep up with more intelligent species that continued to emerge. By this point in evolutionary history, the anatomy and behavior of early hominins was rapidly advancing. Many species walked upright, lived on the ground, and possessed more similar physical characteristics to modern humans. The first species to really resemble humankind was Homo erectus, or the upright man. Homo erectus had human-like proportions, with shorter arms and longer legs relative to its torso. Even its brain size was not so different from a modern human. Homo erectus had an average brain volume of 950 cubic centimeters, with some specimens surpassing 1100. For comparison, the average size today is about 1350 cubic centimeters. Homo erectus expanded upon the crude instruments of the past to create more sophisticated tools, like axes and cleavers. It was also one of the earliest hominins to control fire. Homo erectus may have used fire to cook food, ward off predators, and provide warmth during long, cold nights. Fires may have served as gathering places, where Homo erectus formed more intricate social systems and family bonds. Around these social hubs, some experts believe Homo erectus used primitive forms of symbolic communication, the predecessors to human language, though this is a topic of debate among paleoanthropologists. During its long span on Earth, Homo erectus was among the first hominins to live on multiple continents. Homo erectus originated in Africa, but over many years it migrated into Indonesia and China. Roughly 600,000 years ago, Homo erectus may have encountered Homo heidelbergensis, a tall, strong hominin with a large brain and the tools to prove it. Homo heidelbergensis is known for hunting large game animals, It primarily lived in open woodlands and grasslands alongside horses, deer, rhinos, and even elephants. In the past, killing these big animals was extremely challenging, but Homo heidelbergensis fashioned stone tools and wooden spears. It used these primitive weapons to hunt in cooperative groups and take down animals much bigger than themselves. These large animals provided more food, but their thick bones also made excellent tools, and their hides may have been used as blankets and primitive clothing, giving Homo heidelbergensis an advantage in colder environments. It wasn't until about 300,000 years ago that the first Homo sapiens walked on Earth. Homo sapiens are the species to which all modern humans belong. Compared to other hominins, our faces are flatter, with taller foreheads and less prominent brows. Our legs are also longer relative to our arms, making us among the tallest of all hominins, though the first members of our species probably were not as tall as we are today. Of course, our biggest advantage is our highly developed brain, which gave early Homo sapiens an evolutionary edge. By around 100,000 years ago, we had developed a wide range of tools, including knives and spearheads made from stone, ivory, and bone. We wore clothing from animal hides and controlled fire using hearths. By roughly 40,000 years ago, we expressed ourselves by painting on the walls of caves and sculpting figures out of rock. As our culture developed, our communication systems developed too, creating music, telling stories, and sharing ideas with language. In many ways, Homo sapiens represent the peak of human evolution. But for most of our time on Earth, we were not the only hominins around. For thousands of years, we competed with other species of Homo, notably our close relatives, the Neanderthals. Popular culture often depicts Neanderthals as simple cavemen, but they were about as advanced as early members of our species. In fact, many Neanderthals had larger brains than Homo sapiens and used similar tools. Archaeological evidence suggests that Neanderthals were especially adept at tasks like leatherworking, turning animal hides into warm clothes. Like Homo sapiens, Neanderthals were also socially sophisticated. They operated in small groups and formed strong familial bonds. While it's speculative to imagine exactly what Neanderthals thought about death, some evidence suggests that they performed rituals for the dead, burying them with symbols and items from their lives. The Neanderthals lived alongside Homo sapiens for many thousands of years. We frequently crossed paths, lived in the same territories, and shared the same genes. Neanderthals and Homo sapiens even interbred. To this day, Neanderthal DNA can still be found in billions of people, primarily those with ancestry from Europe and Asia. However, the two species would not coexist forever. The Neanderthals disappeared roughly 40,000 years ago. A combination of factors likely drove them to extinction, but not least among them was the competition they faced from our evolving species. Around this time, populations of Homo sapiens were increasing around the world, including Asia, Europe, and Australia. This global expansion contributed to the extinction of all other species of Homo, leaving us as the only surviving member of our genus. Between 40,000 and 10,000 years ago, modern humans orchestrated a global diaspora, marked by profound technological innovations and rich cultural growth, adapting to Earth's many climates and forging complex social structures as they settled into new continents. Around 10,000 years ago, the agricultural revolution marked a widespread transition from hunting and gathering to farming and animal domestication. We could, for the first time, create our own food, enabling Homo sapiens to form larger, permanent communities. Populations began to rise, and social structures became more organized and complex, turning small mobile groups into tribes, villages, and towns. With these developments came more advanced ideas, like property ownership and early political systems. Several thousand years after the advent of agriculture, the first recognized civilizations emerged in various regions, including Mesopotamia in West Asia and the Nile Valley in North Africa, around 3500 to 3000 BCE. Soon, we entered the Bronze Age, propagating metallurgy and building some of the first colossal structures. As our societies expanded, so did our culture. Trade routes allowed us to not only share resources, but also exchange ideas with others around the world. Using early writing systems, we were documenting events, ideas, and stories, thus marking what is traditionally considered the beginning of recorded history. Over thousands more years, our species underwent many more radical transformations. We built structures loftier than anything our ancestors could imagine. We traversed the world by land and sea, exploring nearly every corner of the planet. With science and mathematics, we began to understand natural phenomena, both studying our planet and searching for our place in the universe. Countless innovations, from steam engines and printing presses to automobiles and computers, sent our civilization spiraling into the future. As advanced as we seem today, the modern era represents only a sliver of our time on Earth. Not so long ago, we were simpler hominins, competing with other primates against the forces of nature. We may be the only species of Homo left, but we would not exist without the many species that made us who we are today.